When you use a car, you have to run engine at the beginning. If you don't run engine, other parts will not run. Engine is the entry point to drive a car. In Java, there is a method. Its name is main method. Without running main method, you cannot run other parts. So if they ask you, what is main method? You will tell them main method is an entry point of every Java program. If you don't have main method, your application doesn't run. Because Java development kit will look for main method at the beginning. It will run main method, then others will run. If you don't have main method, others cannot run. So in every application which is created by Java must have main method. It is like engine in a car. You have a car, but it doesn't have engine. It is not sensible. Actually, it is not car. Main method, from its name, you can easily understand. It is a method, everybody. What is the syntax in main method? Can you see? At the beginning, we are typing access modifier. First step is access modifier. I will skip second step for now because static is very critical keyword. We will learn it later. I don't want to tell anything about it for now because it can confuse you. This is later. In the third step, there is void. What is void? Void is return type. I told you, in every method, you have to put a return type. Over here, void is return type. What is the meaning of void? We know integer is whole number. Decimal is decimal numbers. We know them. What is void? Everybody, method is an action. I told you, when you do an action, you produce something. But it is not 100%. Sometimes you do action, but you produce nothing. If your method doesn't produce anything, you will put void over here. What kind of methods don't produce any data? For example, you created a method, it is printing hello on the console. Just printing something. It is not giving you a new data. You are telling to him, print, it is printing, that's it. A new data is not produced. Just it did what you told. That kind of methods should have void as return type. For example, you created a method, it is just clicking on a button. Your method is clicking on login button, for example. After clicking on login button, you will not get any new data. Just it is an action. After the action, you are not getting a new data. For that kind of methods, we use void as return type. Is it clear when to use void return type? For example, everybody pay attention. I will give you one more example. 5 plus 3 equals to 8. 5 plus 3 equals to 8. Over here, I am using addition operation. Addition operation. And addition operation is producing a new data. This is a new data. There is a production over here. There was no 8, but now I have 8. Can you see addition operation produced a new data? If You get new data from a function, from an action, you should use return type different from void. But look at here, I am telling to Java, hey Java, print 5 plus 3. Can you see? It will just print that one on the console. On the console, you will see 5 plus 3. Do you see any new data over here? Is there any new data on the screen? Nope. There is no new data. So that print action didn't create a new data. It just printing something on the console. For that kind of actions, we will use void return type. Someone's are using Zoom to ask me something, please use just Slack. I don't look at the Zoom chat. I don't look at the raise hand on Zoom. Okay, this is the main method. I talked about first step. I mean, you know the first step. I skipped second step for now because this is the first day. It is difficult to understand the meaning of static in the first day. But void, we talked about it. Main, everybody. This is the method name, main. Main method must have main as name. For main method, you cannot use any other name. Normally, when you create a method, whatever name you want, you can use. But for main method, it should be main. You cannot tell my main, perfect main, good main. It should be just main. It is a single word. And first character is in lowercase because this is method. And then, this is the fourth step. In the fifth step, everybody, can you see inside the method parentheses, I have string brackets and args. We will learn them later. No need to talk about them now. At the end, you have curly braces. I want you to memorize the syntax of main method. Tomorrow in the test, I will ask it to you. Public static void main, string brackets, args, curly brace. You have to memorize it. Is there any question about what the main method is and the syntax of main method? We will use it many times. You will memorize it, no worries. But if you memorize it from the first day, it will be good for you.